You're learning the technical tools to become a data analyst, but how do you think like one? As a business intelligence engineer at Amazon, I work on data projects every day, and today I'll be walking you through a real data project in tech so that you can apply the same thinking. Stay until the end as I will demo the dashboard I create. Now imagine YouTube is testing a new feature where the subscribe button will glow when a YouTuber says subscribe. I'm a data analyst at YouTube, and I'm on a call with the product manager, and she says, can you create a dashboard monitoring the testing of this new feature? Okay, I'll go look at the data. Stop. This is a beginner mistake. When I was first working on projects, I would just dive straight into the data without actually knowing what is it that I'm trying to solve. So now I know better, and I will ask questions before I even touch the data. What questions do I ask? Well, I use this framework. First, I ask questions to identify the goal. Okay, so why do you need the dashboard to monitor the testing? What is it that you're trying to achieve? We're testing the new glow feature on YouTube on a few videos, and we want to know, are users using it? Is it improving the user experience? Because that will improve YouTube's bottom line. Product manager wants to know, are users using the new test feature? Is it improving the user's experience? And it's now my job to partner with the product manager and go through the metrics she defined, which are also called KPIs in the business world, key performance indicators. And these metrics will now measure the goals. So the goal of understanding whether users are using the new test feature can be measured with metrics like subscriber growth. We can look to see if there's a trend of growing subscribers after the new feature was launched. We could also look at watch time and see if that's impacting the amount of time users are now watching it now that they are subscribed. And we can even try to group these metrics by country to see if there's an impact. And this process is collaborative. Most of the time, the product manager will have all her requirements and metrics already identified, and it's my job to go through each of them and make sure that I understand what it is she needs, how that translates into data, and make sure that each of these are actually actionable and impactful to the business. So I'll ask questions like, okay, so I can add subscriber growth by country, but would that really be meaningful if you saw that subscriber growth went up in 90% of the countries except for 10%? Would you need to know the countries in that 10%? That's a good question. I do want to know the 10% and what countries it's dropping in because I want to be able to drill down and see if that's an issue. Then I ask her questions. Who is the audience and user of this dashboard? Will it be herself who needs all the details of the dashboard, or is it an executive who only wants the high-level numbers? A key communication tip is to know who your audience is early on because that will impact the visuals, metrics, basically your whole project. And by knowing who the end user will be early on, that will make your communication and solution way more effective. Will you be the end user of this dashboard? How often do you need the data updated and how much detail do you need? My team will be the main users of this dashboard and we'll need the data updated daily with all the details because I want to then be able to use it to create leadership reports weekly. Now I'll outline the scope of the project. With larger projects, I release them in phases and the first phase is called MVP, minimum viable product, which just means that I'm going to release just the minimum requirements so that the user can use the dashboard, give me feedback, and we can iterate on it rather than me building this really fancy solution all in the beginning and find out that it wasn't what you wanted. So we iterate throughout the process. In the scope, I will outline what will be included in the MVP, what will not, and this really sets limits on my analysis so that I know how much will be included. I document everything from the framework in a design document and make sure we have alignment before I move on to the data. Now, before I even get to the data, I think about what data sets will I need for each of these metrics we defined. I don't know what data is available yet, but I know that for calculating the subscriber growth, I'm going to need a video data set and whether the test feature was on or not, as well as a user data set that'll give me the metrics of whether or not the user clicked subscribe after the feature was on. Now that I have an idea of the data I need, I have to go find it. This requires talking to different teams, researching the domain, going through different data sets, and once I identify the data sets I need, I then load the data into a database. I can use tools like cloud technology, ETL tools, SQL, Python, Excel, and it really depends on where the data is stored, how big the data is, how often you need the data refreshed, as well as what tools are currently available. So tech companies use a lot of cloud technology to load data, whereas another company may use a lot of Excel as their main BI tool. Knowing that I'll have to automate the data to load every day, I use an ETL tool and load the data into a SQL database, which will allow me to now work and explore the data. When exploring the data, I think about, do I have all the data points I need for my analysis? How should I join the different data sets? Are there missing data points? Is the data even accurate? Are there outliers? So this is a phase where I really start to dig into the data and make sure that I have everything in preparation for data analysis. For example, when looking at the user data set, I may see that there are videos listed in there that I can't find in the video data set. And so that would be a data quality issue, which then I need to follow up with the team that is sending me the data and find out if there's an issue there. And I fix all these issues even before I analyze the data, because the quality of your analysis will only be good as the quality of your data. After exploring and cleaning the data, I now work on analyzing it, which just means that I'm getting the relevant information from the data to answer the problem and metrics I defined earlier. Working with big data, a best practice is to aggregate, so combine all your data sets into one reporting table, as that will allow your dashboard to run more optimized. In this step, I use SQL, and what I'll do is I'll join the video and user data sets by video ID to now calculate metrics like subscriber growth. After aggregating and transforming the data, I now connect my SQL database to a BI visualization tool where I'll work on creating visualizations for the product manager. This is where storytelling with visualizations come in. I create visuals thinking about what does a product manager want to see and would this visual even be helpful. I also think about the flow of the visuals, and I want to make sure that there is an order to them and that it's easy to use and understand. So let me walk you through the dashboard I created, just going through the subscriber growth metric and how you could show it for a product manager. I'd first show a high-level number summarizing whether or not the subscriber growth is trending up or down, and if there's a target, such as in this example, I put 25 million as the target that they want to reach with their test feature. How far are we from the target? And look at it in different ways, such as by doing an average versus a median. I'll then also show a daily trend of the subscriber growth rate daily so that you can see whether or not we are meeting our target, and also be able to compare by dates before and after the test feature was launched to see what is the impact of the test launch on subscriber rate. And what I also like to do is allow the user to then drill down from high level metrics. For example, you can see that on June 4th, there's a number of subscribers, but maybe you want to break it down by country. You can click on it and then see that number separated by the subscriber growth by country, which is exactly what she asked for earlier. So I also work on providing the details and giving her the ability to filter the data even more. I meet with a product manager and demo the dashboard like I did so that she can then give me feedback and I can continuously update it and work on the additional metrics. What does a product manager do with the dashboard? Well, this dashboard will allow her to measure the success of the new feature that they're testing. She'll look at this daily to see, is subscriber growth growing daily? If it doesn't, is there a bug that she needs to look into? Is there an issue? She can even use this report to then create leadership reports to monitor whether or not the test feature is working. And my job as a data analyst is to ensure that I understand the problem statement, that I can translate that into data, and I deliver a solution that is actually insightful and actionable. I hope this project showed you how to think like a data analyst, and if you enjoyed it, please like and subscribe, as it really does support the channel. You know how to think like a data analyst, but what is it like being one? I go over what it's like being a data analyst in this video, and I can't wait to see you on that one.